Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today, well, this evening, I am going to be making breakfast for dinner. And as promised, I am going to be making some pumpkin pancakes. Now, I will be honest, I have never actually made these before, so this is going to be a first for me. But I thought it was a good recipe to give a try. Mainly because it's a bit of a change from pumpkin bread, pumpkin muffins, etc. And I thought it would be a good way for folks who might have a can or two of leftover pumpkin in their pantry, from food pantries, to, you know, use it up before it goes past its expiration date, and to make something that is a healthy breakfast option for you and your family. So, the recipe that I'm going to be using calls for some pumpkin pie filling, whole wheat or regular flour, or half and half as some people do, an egg, some white sugar, salt, cinnamon, allspice, pumpkin pie spice if you have it, baking powder, milk. The recipe I have, they use pecan pieces, but I'm not going to go that with that route. Also, they top it with some confectioner's sugar, a dusting. I'm skipping that as I think that while it's tasty, it kind of detracts from the, you know, healthiness of the actual pancake. So I'm not doing that route. They do say that these are thicker pancakes and they do take a little bit longer to fry up. So let me get all my dry goods that I'm going to need here for this recipe together, open up my pumpkin, and let's get cooking. All right, I have a cup of white whole wheat flour. And I'm going to be adding a half a cup of pumpkin. Now, it does say a third of a cup, but I really want to give it a little more pumpkin, I guess you could say, flavoring. So I'm going to be using a half a cup, like so. And what I have left, I won't be wasting because I will most likely make some more pancakes soon. So, yeah, it won't be going to waste. So I'm adding my half a cup of my pumpkin filling here. Adding one egg, next is sugar. Now you can use brown or you can use white sugar. I'm opting to use the white at the moment, so I'm going to be adding 4 teaspoons of sugar. I always gotta double check because sometimes I don't always look correctly. So, 4 teaspoons of sugar. Now, my salt. It calls for, it calls for a half teaspoon of salt. I don't have any iodized salt at this moment. I keep forgetting to get some. So I'm going to use a little bit of Himalayan salt here. Now you can use pumpkin pie spice, or you can use cinnamon and allspice. I'm going to actually use some of the allspice here, and I'm going to add a little bit of cinnamon too. So I'm going to be adding a half teaspoon of the allspice. Along with a half teaspoon of cinnamon. I stirred it up a little bit. It's going to be a little bit crumbly for the moment until we add the milk. And lastly, we need a teaspoon of baking powder. And a half to three quarter cup of milk. If you think it's too thick, you can adjust the milk, it says. So I'm going to start with a half. This is a quarter cup. My other ones are dirty. All right, so we'll start with the half. See how it goes from there. And let's mix all this up. Ow. Ooh, stubbed my toesy on my mop. Ow. Ow, ow, ow. Oh gosh, does that hurt? Wow, smells really good. Really loving the spice scent I'm getting from these. Yum yum. All right, so this is a second batch that I put in, and the reason I'm doing a second batch is I did not like how they were coming the first batch. They didn't spread out at all, and they basically just like stayed clumped together. The batter itself was too thick, I think. And I started off with the half a cup of milk. I wound up adding another quarter cup, still too thick, and I added another. So altogether, a cup of milk. Add it gradually while you're mixing. Works better with this mixture, definitely. As I said, you know, I never made these before, but I definitely think that the consistency actually changed once I added the extra half cup of milk. So yeah, the correct recipe will be down in the description box, and I'm definitely liking the consistency of them now. Not too runny and not too thick. So I have a more traditional sized pancake in there right now. And I want to see how long it takes to do a larger pancake. More, like I said, traditional size. I guess these ones qualify as, say, like, the smaller ones, say, like, jokingly, the silver dollar pancakes, although they're a little bigger than them. And this one is more regular size pancake. So let's see how long it actually takes for the regular size pancake to actually cook. So it took approximately 3 minutes, for the underside to actually cook sufficiently for me to flip it over. So I see. And it should take a minute to 2 minutes for the other side to fully cook as well. Now you'll see I have sausage patties in the other frying pan. That's what I'm actually making. The pumpkin pancakes with some sausage patties. So let me see. Let's see how it. Okay. Let's give it like one more minute there. I want to say this recipe could make 4 large pancakes and 2 smaller sized pancakes. So if you do want to make a bigger batch to feed more people, you definitely want to double the recipe, but remember to double the amount of milk as well, because without more milk, the pancake mix is just a little too thick, at least too thick for my liking. I wanted it thinned out, not runny, but kind of in between. And I think the large ones turned out really good. The smaller ones turned out pretty good too. Just saying though, size-wise, I think this recipe would give you 4 large pancakes and 2 small. Well guys, I think these pancakes are really good. I think the pumpkin combined with the spice end gives these pancakes a really good flavor. They're not overly sweet. They're really good with syrup on top. One of the reviews for this recipe and all recipes, someone said warm the maple syrup up prior to pouring it, and that these are like really, really good. And I imagine with warm syrup, they really, really are. But I'm pleased with it. I think it's a good recipe. I think they're tasty. And, let me know, guys, what you think. And if you make this recipe, if you change it in any way, let me know. So if you like this video, guys, please give it a big thumbs up. If you haven't already, hit my subscribe button, and don't forget to hit that bell so you're notified every time I do upload a new video. Take care, everyone, and I will see you all on my next one. Good night.